This is your News Source Evening Bulletin for today, Thursday the 6th day of December in the year 2018. Here's what we're tracking tonight. As Guyana prepares to become a player in the international oil and gas sector, the Inter-American Development Bank has approved an $11.6 million loan to assist the country in its transition towards becoming a major oil and gas producing state. According to the IDB, the project is designed to support the strengthening and the sustainability of the energy sector in Guyana by contributing to the institutional development of oil and gas governance and the development of cleaner energy sources for electricity operation and generation. The objectives of the loan program are to develop a management and planning framework for Guyana's oil and gas sector and to contribute towards the development of a policy framework so that Guyana may diversify its electricity generation matrix using cleaner or renewable sources. The bank says Guyana's new energy scenario, which will likely yield significant revenues for the government, represents a transformative shift in the country's development trajectory. It embodies a crucial and unprecedented opportunity for economic growth and sustainable development, the statement noted. The IDB added that the conversion of short-term oil wealth into long-term well-being hinges on the capacity of the Guyanese government to adequately manage the new sector and enact productivity-enhancing reforms. It said if handled well, it can boost the overall standard of living in the country. But there is considerable work to be done so that Guyana can enjoy the benefits of its recent and potential oil and gas wealth. The IDB release noted that too often resource-rich countries have become or remain poor as a result of inadequate resource management. Hence, there is an urgent need to improve the governance of Guyana's oil and gas sector ahead of the start of production in 2020. The loan will be funded in two components totaling $11.64 million. The first component will total $5.82 million and will come from the IDB's ordinary capital. The second component will total $5.82 million from the IDB's concessional ordinary capital. The Ministry of Finance in Guyana will be the executing agency for the loan. More news coming up in just a moment.
It's the launch of Guyana Carnival 2019. Four bands, 15 sections, the models, the costumes. You see them first. Choose your design. It's the biggest costume launch to ever hit Guyana. On Saturday, December 8th at the Giftland parking lot. $2,000 in advance, more at the gate. Available at That Look Boutique. Pulse Online, exclusive styles. It's the launch of Guyana Carnival 2019. Just get there. Brought to you by Churches, Stag, and Wave Pale Ale.
Satisfaction, perfection.
The new wave of excitement sweeping Guyana. Wave Pale Ale, a premium, full-bodied, strong, and refreshing alcoholic brew. Crafted to perfection for a bold, young, radical you. Don't settle for anything less. Catch a Wave Pale Ale and ride it today.
Wave Pale Ale.
Crafted to perfection.
Christmas big, plus size big, big things big, we gone big, yeah. It's GTT Christmas. Merry plus size Christmas. Christmas big, plus size big. Size Christmas, yeah. We giving you. It's GTT Christmas. Never plus size Christmas.
Ho ho ho! It's the GTT plus size Christmas. There's always more to love with GTT. Terms and conditions apply. See gtt.co.gy for details.
This Christmas, get a loan for your dream car with an extended repayment term. Spruce up your home with that renovation you always wanted and take advantage of low or no down payment. Get new appliances so you can cook up a storm. You'll get same-day approval. Plus, you can win a getaway to a destination of your choice. Visit RepublicGuyana.com today to find out how.
Republic Bank, we're the one for you.
Welcome back. Minister of Public Health Valdo Lawrence told the National Assembly today that when it comes to procurement practices and holding contractors responsible for delayed delivery of drugs, things are not the same like before. Lawrence and the health sector had come under criticism from the opposition speakers over reports of drug shortages and overpayments and early payment of contractors for drug delivery who were late with those deliveries. In her budget presentation today, the minister outlined how things have changed.
That this time no long time, that we do not sweep things under the carpet, and that those persons who have breached the Procurement Act was written to since in October, and we didn't keep it at the ministry. We copied the financial secretary and the attorney general so that action can be taken, Mr. Speaker.
Minister Lawrence said while some on the opposition side appear to be focusing on the negatives in the health sector, they are failing to talk about the many positives that are happening. According to Minister Lawrence, it is the current government that ensured that the Public Procurement Commission was put in place to monitor and scrutinize all government contracts, including those for the health sector.
I wish to remind this Honorable House that the APNU-AFC government ensured early in its administration that the Public Procurement Commission that was thrown into the doldrums, that it was established in order to provide oversight and scrutiny of all government contracts.
She reminded the opposition that while it was in government, most health supplies contracts were handed over to a close friend of the former president, Barrett Chagdeo, and that type of arrangement no longer continues. Minister Lawrence said that there are several plans for the health sector in the new year. New and rehabilitated residences for medical professionals will be completed, and the Georgetown Hospital will also see several improvements, including a new and improved accident and emergency unit, as well as expansion to the maternity and other wards. She said regional hospitals and other health facilities will also see similar improvements in the new year. Earlier this week, the minister addressed the issue of drug shortages, telling the Department of Public Information that while there are some cases of drug shortages, all health facilities have over 70% of the drugs that they need. In the aviation sector, as the busy holiday season heats up for the airline industry, Copa Airlines today announced that it has gotten the all clear to add an additional weekly flight to the Guyana market. Copa currently operates 4 flights per week between Guyana and Panama with onward connections. From this Friday, the additional weekly flight will come on stream. According to the airline, the Guyana Civil Aviation Authority approved the request by the airline to add the new flight to what is becoming an increasingly busy Guyana route. Copa announced that it will operate the additional flight on Fridays, adding to existing flights on Saturdays, Sundays, Tuesdays, and Wednesdays. The company said its decision to add the additional flight day is based on increasing demand and is part of the airline's ongoing plans to expand and improve its service to the people of Guyana. Copa doubled its flights in 2015 to 4 in response to increased requests from passengers to expand the service. An official of the airline said the airline is very proud to be serving the Guyana market, and the additional flight will cater to the growing demand and will also provide a way by which Guyana's tourism product can be further enhanced. Turning our attention now to the courts, Justice Joan Barlow, who is currently overlooking the Sexual Offences Court, today sentenced a child rapist to life in prison. The sentence was handed down after the man, Rodney Kurzaw, was found guilty of raping a 1-year-old baby girl. The convict offered no statement to the court after the verdict and sentence were handed down. However, Justice Barlow explained that she had found no mitigating factors that could save the man from a life sentence. The judge noted that after the incident, the baby had to be hospitalized for several days due to the severity of the injuries. Justice Barlow said the man had breached trust while taking advantage of the baby girl, and she had no other choice but to slap him with the maximum sentence. The incident reportedly took place on the 27th of July back in 2017, when the child was left in the man's care by a relative. A medical examination found that he had penetrated the child. The emotionless convict was hauled off to prison just after the sentencing. Because of the nature of the case, the media cannot report additional details. And finally tonight, a 30-year-old police constable was today charged and granted bail after he was allegedly caught with several rounds of ammunition in his possession while not being the holder of a license to carry same. The police constable Romel Cato appeared before the city magistrate Faith McGusty and pleaded not guilty to the charges. The court was told that last Saturday in the Brigham area, he was nabbed with 13.32 rounds of ammunition and a .38 round in his possession, while not being the holder of a firearm license at the time. He was taken into custody and grilled about the fine. The prosecutor in the case objected to bail, but the magistrate disagreed with that position and offered the man bail in the sum of $100,000 and ordered him to return to court on the 14th of December. And that's your News Source Evening Bulletin for tonight. I'm Gordon Mosley reporting.